What up, everybody? It's day 215, Making Songbringer, and today I'll be polishing stuff up. Just working on all these things on my list. Man, I can't wait to get rid of some of these things on my list. Just not get rid of them, but to polish up the game so I don't have to have these things on my list. I'm one of those people that when there are a lot of things are on my plate, I just start working on them like crazy. What's up, Momir? Welcome, welcome. How you doing today? So what I'm working on now is some effects for the edges of the screen. So for example, I got it so you can never get knocked off the edge of a screen. Also, you can never hit an enemy and have them bounce off the screen. Oh, I almost had that guy could show up, but yeah. So next, let me work on this other thing here. What's up, Barking Garage? Boogie. Yeah, I'm good, man. close. Yeah, so all these things right here, I got my list of stuff to do right into high priority and low priority. Low priority is pretty long, right? And then ideas. These things are like things I know I'm not gonna be able to get done right now, but still I love them. I'm having them on my list. So anyways, I'd love to be able to get these high priority things at least done before I release the what up, Azenris? Before I release the alpha version later this month. So that's like basically 2 weeks I have to get these approximately 20 or 25 things done here. I already fixed two this morning though, so that's big. This one's kind of easy too. So I want to hide foes that if they're still off the screen when you're about to go to a new screen. So there's two modes an enemy has of getting on the screen. One is they just appear there, right? They're already there on the screen. I think this screen up here. See, there you saw that bug I was just talking about. Yeah, so these, they're appearing off the screen and then jumping on the screen. Man, all these areas are like that over here. That one too. Anyways, there's two types of modes. They either appear already on the screen, or they come off from the edge of the screen. So sometimes if a foe appears on the edge of the screen and then for some reason decides to jump off the screen or something like that, somehow they can stay off the screen, and as you're walking from one area to another, they're visible for a second, so it just looks really weird. So it's just a tiny little thing, but it was related to some other things I did this morning. So while I've got this kind of momentum, I'm just gonna fix that. Yeah, right. Yeah. Yeah. That's totally. Yep. Yeah, and some of his videos are like really crazy, and then some of them you're like, oh my god, that was kind of like really good advice right there. So you never know what you're gonna get, but yeah. Okay, so simply just a matter of setting the sprite to be visible or invisible. I know where to do this then. Okay, in area we have this function called move entities. This is when you're about to slide from one area to another. It moves all the entities. And then it creates, so if you're on one screen, it moves them off to the side. It creates the new area at 0, 0, and then moves the camera so that it all slides. So basically what we want to do is if an enemy or any kind of entity, I guess, is off the screen completely when we're about to do a move, then they should be invisible. And it should be before they're moved as well. So this is where move entity. And I think we'll stick with AI for now, because I'm not sure, there might be some things which are desirable to have visible off screen. Like for example, trees, dirt, bushes, rocks, those kind of things. Sometimes I put those off the screen on purpose so that you can see the tops of them or the edges of them, or you can see them when you're transitioning. So if ent.ai.isEmpty, and so if it has an AI and it's not within the bounds of this area, and they have the area bound factor. So and dot move dot flags and k move area boundary, and this thing is not within the margin. Let's hide it. Int dot render dot sprite dot set visible false. Also, this thing needs a render component for sure. But other than that, if it doesn't have a movement flat movement component, that's fine, because that'll just be zero. And the same thing with the collision size, accessing it there. If it just accesses a blank one, that's fine. Okay, so let's see if that works. So basically, I'll allow some entities, some of these jitterbug enemies to pile up a little bit on the edges, and then I'll try moving to a different screen and see if that little thing works there. Oh, see there, I can see one was there. Oh, no, I don't think that worked. We'll set a breakpoint here. Hey, what's up, Thomas? Guten Abend to you, too. What's Abend mean? Sorry. I know what Guten means. Let's see if his logic is right. Render's not empty. AI's not empty. We have the K-move area boundary. Oh! No, these entities are never going to have their area boundary. Oh, evening. Oh, all right, evening. Evening. Evening, good sir. Top of the morning to you. Top of the evening. All right. Yeah, so what I was trying to do there was to block jib. So jib, we don't want jib to ever be hidden. We don't want his sprite to go invisible. So, yeah, well, I guess I got an easier way to do this. Yeah, we can just do this. If e.ai.mood. Mood? I thought mood was one of... Oh, ant.ai. What's up, Arcane? Thanks, man. Can you pre-order from Steam? No, you can't actually pre-order from Steam yet, because the Steam page is not totally done. It's not like live or whatever. What up, Marza? But you can order from Humble Bundle. It's the same thing. So songbringer.com pre-order. This gives you Humble Bundle, which gives you a Steam key anyways, eventually. So once whatever level you order at. So if you order at the $64 level, you get the game this month, $32 level in 2 months, and then this one you get it when it comes out in like 4 months or whatever. But anyways, that gives you a Steam key anyways, but it's kind of like pre-ordering from Steam. But basically, no, you can't order a Steam game that isn't out yet. So even though I do have a Steam page all set up and stuff like that, you can't order from here yet. So once this goes live and the game's actually done, that's when you can actually order on Steam. I'm polishing up a bunch of things. Is this I got all these high priority things I got to get done before the game is released this month. So I got about 20 of these things on here. I think I can get 2 to 4 of them done a day. And so I think I can get it done in 2 weeks. What's up, man? Yeah, I just talked about that. What's up, DM John? I get it. Yeah. Nope, polishing bugs. There, that's a pretty simple way to do it. If this entity is in the mood off screen, right, and they are not within the margin, then set them invisible. So let's try that one more time. Double all health. Yeah, all health is going to be doubled, and then all the damages are going to be doubled too, and defenses, all that. So basically, right now there's only two integers. So the quantity of a heart or a demon's tooth or whatever you're going to call it down there in the bottom right, the actual health, there's only two numbers per. So the goal there is to do is to make them all four. So that's what double all health means, so that there'll be more room for little bits of damage. So each heart is in quarters instead of halves. What up, Alex Pita and Zella Ethan? Cool, man. I'm glad somebody bought your album. Cool, man. All right, man. Yeah, I know it's late for you guys. No, you cannot pre-order on Steam, because you can't buy a game on Steam that's not out yet. So even though the page is live, the product is not actually live. So the only way to pre-order it at this point is through Humble Bundle from the website. Nice. Is that 666 flipped over? All right, so let's see what this entity is that it's hiding here. This ent ID is 6467. Yeah, cool. It's a jitterbug. Its position component is the thing we really want to check, though. X, Y. X is 0, Y is 0. So it's in the bottom left corner. Yeah, this jitterbug is like, should be invisible for sure. Oh, really? Huh? Oh, is the Humble Bundle pre-order include day one Steam key? Day one Steam key. I think you mean when the game comes out. Yeah, it does. The Humble Bundle order, if you order on Humble Bundle, it says it pretty clearly there. I think it doesn't say it clearly enough. Let's see. So yeah, when you pre-order the game, you get the game when it's released via Steam key. So yeah. Okay, is there any way I can make that clear? Or were you just not even looking at the site or something? Okay, let's see if that worked now. Let's try it out experimentally, or just visually, not so technically. Actually, no, let's keep that breakpoint. Let's run it one more time. See what, if we hit it again. Cool, position. Yeah, this one's way off screen. Okay, I think that worked. Let's see. Yeah. So yeah, the big advantage of pre-ordering the game is that you get your name in the credits and on the main menu. So the very main menu is going to say your name just because you pre-ordered. Okay, there's some jitters built up. I did not see any of that time. Just let a few more of them build up here. I think those were in the air. Oh, man. I guess I don't know if that's working. Yeah, it's going to take a bit for sure, because the Steam keys are not going to... If you order the $16 version right now, you're not going to get your key until the game is actually ready to have a key, which is going to be right when it releases. So, it's whatever you prefer. Yeah, I don't know if that worked, because it said visible false, but... Here, maybe something else is affecting its visibility or something. So let's go int.render.sprite. Set color. We'll make it a red sprite really quick. And maybe set its opacity too. So just try setting every... Maybe it's blend funk. So that should reveal something. Cool, man. Good for you. All right. That guy was there. Yep. That guy was definitely off screen right there. Oh, man. So weird. Maybe his mood wasn't off screen anymore, actually. So. We could check for the faux entrance B. You will find jib head in the bad if you will not. Oh, I get it. A jib head in the bag, you mean? Oh, okay, let's do it this way, because I was trying to avoid jib, right? Oh, no, I got a better way of doing that. So if the collision category... There, so if it's a faux, let's try that. All right, Marza. Good night, man. Oh, there. I think it might have worked. So there should be a few enemies building up over there. Yeah, I saw a shadow of one. Cool, I think it's working now. In fact, we can prove it by setting, instead of turning off visibility, we can just set the color to be red. And we should be able to walk off the screen and see a red enemy now. Buona notte, caro. Yeah, there was one. Cool. Okay, it's working. Bam! All right, we don't need this stuff anymore. Cool. All right, bam. Oh, that's one off the list, baby. Let's go check it one more time, though. Yeah. Yeah, what does Caro mean? What did I just say? Nice. All right, cool. That's nice. That's a really good bug fix. Uh-oh, it means deer. All right, next one on the list is to pick up items as you slide from area to area. Okay, and this is pretty easy. We've got influx phase slide. This is the phase which carries the player from area to area. We've got an animate method. Let's give it a tick method as well. Virtual void tick. I think they're double deltas. Yeah, double delta. Cool. All right, so back to phase slide. All right, so inside this tick method for the phase slide, we're going to check the player's position and pick up any items. And I'm gonna mimic how the top hat works. Top hat picks up items as well. I think there's actually a function called pick up item. Pick up items at it. Well, I guess that would have to be if it collides with one. Here it is. Mood boomerang in. Yeah, so it's looking for a collision with an item, and if it finds it, it picks it up. Cool, we want to mimic that same behavior there. Cool. All right. This should, let's see if this even works. It should work. So what we'll need to do is we need to create an item that's right on the border. What's up, professional novice? What's up, players for fun? This is for Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, Android, basically everything. PlayStation 4, Xbox One, possibly 2. All right, yeah, so we'll need to kill, actually kill an item there, or kills an enemy.
What's up, Bill? How you doing?
Oh,
that work? If we could kill an enemy right on the edge of the screen, that would really simplify this. What's this? What? Oh. You can't inline these methods without throwing them in the header, I think. All right, let's run without building, and we will try and kill an enemy right on the edge of the screen. So let's let out a jitter. Come on. Oh, missed. Oh, I know what we can do. Give all the jitters only like one hit point, so they'll just die right away. It'll make this easier to test. So jitter, hit points, one. So now they're just easy targets. Still compiling though. All right, well, this will take a sec, but I think that'll work. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. It will eventually come out on iOS too. But primarily it's Windows, Mac, Linux. It's a Steam game primarily. And I'm also really excited to bring in on Retro VGS if their Kickstarter succeeds. We'll see. And their Kickstarter launches actually this week, so that's going to be cool. If you guys don't know what Retro VGS is, it's the return of the cartridge for gaming. Like, we're talking Super Nintendo, we're talking Nintendo, all the cartridge-based game systems. They want to bring that back for new games. Brand new games coming out on cartridges again. Mom, what are you talking about? Come on. Oh, I missed him. Can't see. There we go. Scan him, Jib. Give me an item. Oh, it's got an item. Oh, it picked it up like three times. Oh. Oh, nice, nice. What I have in mind for controls on the iPad, two things. One, I want to do Bluetooth gamepad, so if you do have a gamepad, you'll be able to just play with your gamepad. But secondly, I'm going to do just virtual D-pads. I've done games where you touch the whole screen to move, and I'm not sure I particularly like those. It's kind of difficult to get a good control scheme on iOS, but I'm open to suggestions, so... And I'll be live streaming all the development of the iOS version too, so I'm sure I'll be getting some good feedback from you guys on that. Hey, we're all stupids. We're all stupid at heart. Or at least I'm stupid. I'm with you, man. I use the stupid version tracker. Git, the stupid content tracker. We love you, Git. You're so good. All right, so it picked up the item, but it sounded like it kept picking up the item over and over and over and over. So I think it wasn't removing the item or something. Let's see what happens in pick up item. It's not like we're purchasing the item. Yeah, here's the diamond. It would have deleted the entity, which would have happened right after the update. Huh. All right, yeah, I'm definitely open to suggestions there. uh, Oh man. Or maybe Vlad's Vlad's controls. Vlad's got some sweet eye base control for phones. That's cool. I guess that would probably be really hard for playing a game though, because you have to like focus on the screen, and then it pops up a little window and you can do stuff. Okay, let's figure out what's going on by setting a breakpoint. Right, give me an item. Give me an item. Nothing? Oh, lame. I missed one. Okay, let's try that again. Day 330, remove ads and app purchase. Definitely no in-app purchases or ads in this game. Oh, come on, give me an item. There we go. All right, okay, I'm gonna let it run once. Yeah, see, it's picking it up again. Okay, now we gotta do that again. So, okay, well, I've just verified that the problem is that it's running that twice. Either so it's basically it hasn't removed the item. So there's got to be a reason why. Yes, right? Come on. I'll take it. Yes, that's fine. I'll take some health. Okay, so let's see what happens in here when it picks up the item. Should be what up, Blood? Welcome. We were just talking about you and your awesome eye-based technology for phones. Okay, here we go. We got the item. Cool. It found the item. We're not crafting this item. So num craftable. Yeah, I shouldn't get that. We're doing that loop. Cool. We're not on the Smith. Definitely shouldn't have a price. We get into this. Yeah, totally. What up, Jin Artor? Sorry, I hope I'm saying your name right. Is it Jean or Jin? Wait, good question, Alex Pita. What do you mean? Well, it's your birthday. All right. Happy birthday, man. Confetti. Confetti. Yeah, congratulations, man. You doing something special today? Anything special? What up, BBL Zone? Welcome to the stream. We're just celebrating the fact that it's Vlad's birthday today. And he's awesome. Gene. Okay, Gene. Or Gene. So green. Gene. All right, Gene. Got you, man. Gene. What up, King Nothing? So what I'm doing here is I'm making this little this effect so you can pick up items if you're walking from screen to screen. And it's right now it's able to pick up the item, but it's picking it up twice. So I'm trying to debug the fact why it's figuring why it's not deleting the item here. Area. Oh. Because this is no longer part of that. I got it. Sing him a song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear blood. Happy birthday to you. Confetti. fireworks, explosions. Yes, best birthday ever. Nice. Oh, it's the whole weekend. Right on. Kapow. Yeah, I guarantee this is not going to be able to find this entity. Because it's the wrong area. So back here, pick up item. Area is old area, probably. No way. Who did this? Who made this graphic? Somebody put Jim back here. Did you make this, Boogie? Yeah, so what is this area? Area is gonna be the wrong one. So this, what is 200? Yeah, there's a problem. It's correctly identified this item. But it can't remove it from the area. Okay, so that's the problem. How do we solve this problem? Because as we're transitioning from area to area, we have two different areas to kind of be mindful of. Oh, all right, all right. Yeah, nice. He should. Nah, he doesn't yet, but let's make him say it right now. Hey, listen. Now we need a story element for that. He'll probably say it next time now. San Diego. This is Comic-Con. Oh, I've been here. I get it. Alright, so what to do? How do we make it so both kinds of areas can remove? I guess we could pass in an area into pick up item. Am I a cosplayer with? No, not really. I haven't ever tried it. I'm not against it or anything. I just haven't really ever done that. Watch out, Link. Watch out. Right? Yeah, right. Yeah. I think they got it. A lot of people at Comic-Con would get that, I'm pretty sure. But I don't know. Okay, we got pickup item. That might... Yeah, we might be able to pass in the area into pickup item. So we would do it here by getting the old area. We would do it here. Could probably just pass in area from... Well, this is a long function. Yeah. Yeah, there you go. Who doesn't like seeing a woman dress up or down? So here's some uses of area. We can just grab area. Here's another instance of looking for it. So we would just call world area. Yeah, this is, let's just do it that way. There's no really need to check this too much. So let's, yeah, start compiling that. Pick up item. Yeah? What? What do you want me to do? What? Watch out? Watch out for what? All right, so this is going to be world area. Old area, pause. Hey, what's up, Barkor? It's going great, man. Just working on some bugs and polishing up the game for the release that's coming up in 2 weeks. Yeah. Basically, just anything slutty. All right. Oh, I never knew that's where that came from. Gene. Helping me see the world the way it is. This is your gift? Oh, I don't know what this is going to be. Yeah, bam! Oh, that's awesome. Heck yeah, that'll be the best gift ever. No, definitely not. Right? Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, it was kind of stressing until last night. I got a lot of progress done on the list, so. And then this morning I made some good progress, too. So, yes, I guess I am a little bit stressed, but not too much. I'm adding in bugs. Oh, man. Hey, thanks, Pixel Bards. So what is all procedurally generated in the game? Everything. Well, not everything. It goes down to the tiles. So let me run without building so I can show you it. So it generates these worlds. First of all, I'll show you the map. So first thing it procedurally generates is a whole world based on your world seed. So you enter six letters, right? This world is called Dingle. And then it generates this whole map based on that, right? So this is the overworld map. And it also generates all the dungeons. So there's 9 different dungeons, and all those use a different world generator, a different algorithm, a procedural algorithm for everything. But everything is based on those 6 letters. So inside every one of these areas, like this area right here is the start point for this world, where you start the game. And inside this area, every single one of the tiles is also procedurally generated. So So tiles are things like, this could be a rock, or it could just be some grass, or it could be a entrance to a dungeon or whatever. So down to the actual tiles, it actually uses algorithms for everything. So there's absolutely no loading. So here's one really big function which generates the levels, right? So this is like creating it's a big algorithm which generates every single tile for all the levels and everything. So yeah, it generates down to the tile-based level, and there's a little bit of ground texture-based procedural texture generation as well, but not all everything else. Everything else in the game is actually, like all the art, for example, is not procedurally generated. So, for example, here's a pillar. graphic, right? This pillar I just drew by hand and put in the game. It's not procedurally generated, so. Yeah, of course it is. All right, right on, Pixel Bards. Right. Or I don't know how to explain it easily. All right, let's grab the area. Auto ref area. World area. All right, so now we've got the area. This is the change hit points method. Right? Or trivial. Yeah, that's a good word for it. For anything you don't want to explain. Oh, it's just trivial. Pass in area here. Here we've already got the area. This is probably, no, that's the same method. This is a long ass method. This really needs to be simplified, put into smaller methods. Lord, Lord, oh Lord. Long methods, bad. Right? That method, yeah, that method I was just showing there for that algorithm, whatever, was definitely too long as well. Yeah, thanks, Alex Pita. Appreciate you saying that, man. It is better every minute, but it's more like better every day. You know, every day it gets a little better in it. So it takes all day to get to see something, right? Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah. Science, bitch. Bitch. Oh, yeah, we don't need that anymore. There. Yeah, you are, man. You are. I wouldn't say it's very little either. I think it was your excitement that got the Kickstarter to succeed so well. You really helped kick it off, man. Oh, this area. Yeah, this one needs to be. Just get the area again. There. Here we go. This is world area, unless we have area already. Wait, this is the collision system tick. We definitely want to pre-cache world area before we call all this. Actually, no, we don't really need to cache this unless we're going to reuse it a bunch in this method. So world area is fine to be here. And then we can, that should probably, it's a trade-off. Yeah, buddy. Boomerang out. Yeah, this one also could pass in world area. So basically what I'm doing here, if anybody's just joining the stream, I'm making it so the player can pick up items as they walk from an area to an area by making the pick up item method more flexible, but you can pass in which area that you want to pick up that item from. And this one is, do you already have world area? I guess we get it there. It might be useful to get it again. Yeah, we might as well just get it. Efficiency. You could tell I'm part German because I make things more efficient as whenever I can. But you can also tell I'm not entirely German because my code is sometimes crazy. Okay. All right. This should be able to run now. We can go and try out this thing. So if this works, we'll be able to kill an enemy right on the edge of the screen, walk across from area to area, pick up the item, but only pick it up once. Because that was the problem before. The problem was that you pick up the item multiple times, like over and over and over and over and over until you got to the next screen. ShamWow! Smiley GLaDance, hey, hey! Sign up today! So I figured out my Xcode builds so slow when I'm streaming. It's like because OBS to broadcast uses like 100% of one CPU, so that's why it builds so slow. Also because it's C++ and the compiler for C++ is a... Hey there, Jib just said, what did he say again? What was that? Listen, hey, listen. Come on, Jib, get an item off that guy. Yeah, buddy, you got one. Oh, we missed it. I can't believe I missed it. Hey, listen, that's right, he said, hey, listen. What's a GoFundMe? That would be great. I could use some more funding right now because all my Kickstarter funds will run out in December. And I would love to be able to release this game in March. But at this point, it's probably going to be January. Which just means that basically the game won't be as awesome as I can make it before it first gets released. Oh, no item? Okay, let's try it one more time. Ungerman? Who's Ungerman? Ah, missed. Oh man, come on, Jim. Try one more time. I can't believe I missed the diamond. So close. Oh, it's about to hang. Uh-oh. Oh. I get it. Yep, I missed it. Totally. Well, come on. Oh, dude, these guys are too quick. Come on. Yeah, oh, that might be it. Come on. Get an item. No, dude, what? Dude. I know, right? Seriously, let's make it 100% diamond drop. This is getting crazy. Item probability, something like that. Item probability, here we go. Make it 100% items. I hear ya. That's how I was yesterday. I was too tired to talk. But I kept talking anyway. Didn't make any sense. Nobody could understand me. Oh, and what's up with this? Little random crash here. I don't know what's going on. Let's pause and see where the game's at. It's in... Preload sounds in Coco's Dension. Coco's Dension just hung on us. So maybe that's what those random crashes are. It's just the Coco's Dension sound engine. Oh yeah, come on. You know it's 100% item drop now. You gotta drop one. Yes! Oh! We picked up one item. That's all we wanted. Yeah! Alright. Yet another bug off the list. That was an important thing. Done. A high priority item done. Bam! This thing's worth checking in now. Sweet. Okay, let's turn off that whole 100% probability. And we'll check in this code. Yeah, right, right, right. But it was because of being stoned the day before, it made me tired the next day. But still, I guess I was a little stoned. Yeah. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Okay, so we want to turn that back. So this is a little bit of debug code. Jitter. Undo that. So it has 4 health by default. Foes. Undo these changes. So we put that back. There we go. Cool. We've got a little hey listen element from Jib. We've got hide off-screen foes. That worked. Yes. Yeah. On Sunday, we had a little party. We went to Shakespeare in the Park and all that. I got high. Bad move, dude. Made all my code that night horrible. Horrible. All right, here we go. Yeah, and this is the tick, which picks up items as we transition from world to world. And then the only other change was to pass in the area into pick up item. So this is 2 bugs fixed. Bam. That's a lot, actually. Those are 2 important things. Sometimes it takes all day to get 2 things done. Yeah. I do. I always stand when I'm streaming, at least. And then I stand partially for the rest of the day, too. But mostly for the rest of the day, I sit down. Yes, bad. Oh, Jalapenos Bud, this is a really great question here. How do you handle the polishing phase of game development? For me, it really sucks. I know the feeling, dude. Usually for me, it really sucks, too. But with this game, I've kind of gotten lucky and found a way that kind of has made it easier. Because usually what happens, if anybody's not familiar with the polishing phase of game development, you spend months just like fixing bugs, like this huge list of my bugs that I've got to fix, which is weighs on my soul. I'm like, oh my God, I got all these bugs to fix and things to do and stuff. But anyways, and so it gets stressful because you're like, oh my God, there's one more. And every one of these sometimes releases, you find another bug in there. So sometimes it's like you're working through this list and you can never get through it and stuff. It can be horrible. It can be incredibly stressful and a horrible experience. But with this game, I've actually kind of gotten lucky because I've released it now 2 or 3 times. Yeah, totally. It is. Yeah. But I've already released this game twice. Yeah, twice. So I did a preview build during the Kickstarter phase. So for the month of May, I think. Yeah, May and end of April, I was doing the Kickstarter. And so I did a release at the end of that month, and I really pushed hard, and I polished up the game a little bit. So basically I've broken it into like 3 or 4, or even, and I guess it will be a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There'll be 5 polishing phases before I ever release the game. And so what that's done is it's made it easier. It's put it in more bite-sized chunks. You know, like I can get 10 to 20 things done each time or something like that, and break that up into only a week or two instead of being months long of polishing and all that. So basically, it's just a lot easier if you break it into smaller chunks. And my biggest thing about game development is that you really want to enjoy it. You know, that's why I always say to follow your heart. So if you're not enjoying doing this stuff, ask yourself why. And maybe you should back off for a minute. Maybe go take a a week break or something like that. And sometimes you can take a week break and come back and it's like all of a sudden it's enjoyable again. And so that's the thing, you know, first of all, enjoy what you do. If you're not enjoying it, ask yourself why. And second of all, break it into smaller chunks. And I think the polishing phase can be easier. Yeah. Good question. All right. All right, cool. Ready for the next one? Yeah, of course, man. Of course. I love getting great questions like that. Thanks, Darren. Because, like, you know, I hope out there, somebody out there that saves you from, you know, having to pull your hair out or something like that, saves you some time, makes your whole experience with game development better. Like, I love answering questions like that because, I don't know, it's a great feeling for me if I do end up helping you in that way. So, okay, you know what? Since I've gotten four things checked off my high priority list today, I'm actually going to save the rest of my high priority items for tomorrow. And I'm going to go and do a couple low priority items. So one thing I want to do is taller trees. So these will be branches. What do we got? We still have at least an hour. Yeah, we got plenty of time to do this. So tall trees and squishing grass. In fact, oh, I kind of want to do the squishing grass first. Done. All right, we're going to do squishing grass first. So let's put the player at the very beginning of the game. 7-0-0. That's where this world starts. And we'll make it so you can squish the grass. So when you're walking across grass, just make it so you can, it just flattens out or bends over or something. So there's all this grass here on the screen. The goal is just to make it so when you step on the grass, it's like it bends over a little bit. And I want to do it without it being too expensive, too. So there's a whole lot of these little grass entities, right? They all are separate entities. So maybe I guess I could combine them into smaller entities or like groups of entities. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, what game are you making, man? What you working on? Okay. Maybe. Yeah, that might be a simple way to do it. Yeah, totally. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah? Was it on the idea list? It probably was. Okay, well, if we were to just do this the expensive way would just be give every single entity of grass, every one of these blades of grass, its own create grass tile, I guess this is it. Yeah. Create plant tile. Cool, right on. Nice. Well, as I say to everybody, I would love to see and watch your progress and root for you and you know, encourage you and stuff. So if you want to like share your progress, please share a link to your game, share screenshots. It doesn't have to be today, like, or whatever. Whenever you have stuff you want to share, feel free to share it. Yeah, here's where we could give it some grass right here. Inside this method, I mean, we would give it a collision component, and then I would have to have a certain collision category. Oh, you do? Oh, cool, man. What's your link? Yeah, Renazor. Totally, yeah. This is big right here. It's a big point. If you actually release a game, you've done something that very few people ever do. Because most people start games, you know, if in the actual sphere of game developers, you know, this is a small niche of all of humanity. We are this small niche, right, of game developers. And let's say there's 1 million of us or whatever, or 2 million or whatever, 100 million. It doesn't really matter. There's an even smaller amount of people that actually release the game that they start. So that's a very, very huge thing to be proud of if you finish a game. Even a small Ludum Dare jam or Ludum Dare or a game jam or whatever, that's saying something that you actually finish that. Sweet, you're getting your sanity back? That's awesome. Cool, man. Awesome. Right on. Right on, Alpinos. So we would need some kind of filter. I guess it would be a K filter neutral, or no. Neutral is something the player cannot walk on, I think. Yeah, is it weird? I know that feeling. I definitely know that feeling. It's great. It can be really weird to share your stuff, right? What should we use here? What should we use? Let's see. Let's go look at the player's collision category or movement. Yeah, so the player cannot step on neutral. So we do need to do something else if we're going to make it so that you can step on these entities of grass. It would probably be one of these things, like static, water, sky. I guess we could just call it grass for now. Or ground. Call it ground, I guess. All right, let's get that compiling so we don't have to worry too much about that. Cool, right on. Hello, Knight, or Kent. Yeah, this is Kent, man. This is C++. Oh, I forgot a comma. Duh. All right. Okay, so now we've got that K filter ground, which is good, basically like stuff you can walk on that's on the ground. I'll add it into the constants, into the words for filter types. So, okay, filters, here we go. So we can parse this too. So entities can perhaps, you know, I can filter things in or out based on actual property lists and things that I load, you know, like from data. So basically it's making that data driven, the ability to be data driven. So, okay, now we got that as a word, as a filter word. We should be able to just go after we've created a plant tile in area creation. It's only creating one entity. So create grass tile. We can literally just add another component right here. So we'll do that. Entity, add component. Autocomplete isn't my friend while it's compiling. Add component. We're gonna add a collision component. Oh yeah. No, this doesn't work that way. It's entities.back, new collision component. Now collision components. Okay, category is gonna be K filter ground. Mask, K filter none. Size, okay, we're gonna get a pretty small size. Probably something like 6x4. And damage 0. Parent area layer. Okay, and now let's make it so the player just tromps like over, just tramples the grass. So, I guess we would put this in the move system. Tick. If we are the player, so we're gonna step on the grass. I think we need to do a vector of eids for this. This is kinda be an expensive method to call, actually. Remove the player already. Footsteps, set listener pause. Yeah, I guess we have moved the player. Oh yeah, move system move, cool. So we moved this player, now we're gonna call collision system. Get collisions into eids for eid, e.id, mask, k filter, ground. That's all we want to get, just the ground entities at the position of the player, size of the player, and that's it. So for every one of these grass entities, I think we're already using eid, so we want to use id for this one. We'll get we're basically just going to trample over them. We'll try by just turning them on their sides for now. So we'll do a rotation. We'll rotate the sprite. That ought to work because the anchor point is the bottom middle. So rotating the sprite ought to work just nice. So we'll go get the render component. For this grass. And just render.sprite.setRotation. -90 or something. Yeah. Basically this is the, let's see if it works. I don't know if it will, we'll see. Might be kind of expensive because there's a hell of a lot of these grass entities. Oh yeah, it's kind of working. Nice. I mean, it doesn't look that good yet because it's like it needs to either go to the left or the right, maybe not always the same rotation. Okay, let's start with making the rotation a little bit more random. All right, Momir, good night, man. Right, it's kind of funny, right? So we'll do if this thing doesn't already have a rotation. What's up, Pete Wally? Oh yeah, kill the animation. Good call, Boogie. I'm working on making so you can trample the grass right now. Get rotation is not equal to zero, or is equal to zero. I'm pretty sure this is a float. Yeah, float. Okay. render.sprite.stopAllActions. So that'll kill the animation. And now let's randomly do eat from, we'll say it should be at least 45 degrees in its angle, right? So we could just do from zero for the angle. The angle we want is either negative 45 to negative 90 or 45 to 90. So let's create some code that'll do that. So basically I'm thinking we could do just negative 45 to 45. And then if it's less than zero, we add minus 45. Or if it's greater than zero, we add 45. So that'll give us those two sections of the circle. So, float angle equals, drand F01 times, I think a quarter or 45 degrees is, dodge whale. Good point. Really good point. Yeah. It should definitely rotate depending on the direction you're running for sure. Good call. Very good call. Yeah, Boogie too. Thank you guys for pointing that out. Okay, still it should be a little bit random, but it should be based on the way you're walking. So if you're walking to the east, it should rotate to the to the right or clockwise. And if you're walking to the west, it should be counterclockwise. So we'll just grab the current motion of the player and apply all that and stuff. North, I guess you would want to go all the way around. And south, you would leave it alone. So in all of these things, we want to have a slight bit of randomness. So Float angle equals, oh, you could scale y. Oh, that's a good idea. Okay, so north and south, we can scale the y so it's a little bit shorter. And that will make it look like it's trampled and hit the ground. Yeah. Okay, so we still need this random angle a little bit. We'll use m pi over 4. Oh, wait, no, this thing is, this thing's set rotation is in degrees. Okay, so I gotta think in degrees, not radians. So, 90. No, we don't want to hold 90 now. Let's do just 45. So there's our randomness. So the players, so let's just set rotation to be angle. So if the player's last movement direction, E dot move dot, is it compass dir? There's a couple different dirs. We have, yeah, there's compass dir is the current direction you're currently moving in. But then you can also sometimes have these velocity vectors. So we should use the last east-west or the last north-south direction. All right, so there, if we have some east-west movement, we'll add to the angle. If the last east-west direction is west, then we want to subtract at least, so we've got an angle that's 0 to 45 right now. And we want to take half of that. Let's make that a constant. So rand angle times negative a half minus, so now after we've got that, that'll shift the 45 degree angle to centered, and then we want to make it so it's also another like 90, minus 90. Okay, and then if we're moving to the east, then we want to add half the rand angle. Plus, that'll get it to, wait. No, you don't need to add half rand angle. Subtract half the rand angle. Fun fact. Let's just do this. Yeah, so we can just build that into the both those. So angle minus equals 90. And plus equals 90. But that could possibly make it go further than the ground. So yeah, oh man, we need to just do this is so funny. Basically, we want to take that off now. And then we want this to just be negative 90 and this to be 90 minus half the rand angle. So that would be, if the rand angle is 45, we've got this much, and we add 90. Yeah, and that would be from that to that. Oh, so we want to subtract the whole rand angle. All right, there. I like that. Let's try it again. So let's try it. This is not going to have any north-south movement, but if we just move to the east and west, let's see if that looks good. Yeah, of course, man. Totally. Yeah, I think that worked. This is great. You trample the grass. But now we just got to get the north-south to go. Okay, and I also want to make it a little bit smaller. So you really, each one of these blades of grass or whatever, let's see, let's actually look at the graphic for that. Yes. Sprites, overworld. Oh yeah, so each one of these has a few different sprites inside it. No wonder they're kind of looking a little bit weird when you rotate them. I guess they should squish on the X first. Yes, triple PC warrior. Oh, that's awesome to see. Yeah, actually, let's compress them a little bit on the X before we rotate them so they look a little bit more squished. But I would say this thing should have a width of maybe, yeah, I guess 6 is actually all right. Let's make it smaller. I think a smaller width for these things will really help them look more grassy. So yeah, let's do 3 and 1. And then let's squish them on the X. You wish there was a jibby mode? Oh yeah! Oh, how do we, is there any way to add those? Hopefully this game gets popular enough that Twitch just has to do it. They'll make an emote for jib. That would be that. My life would be fulfilled at that point if Jib was an emote. Yeah, oh, 4 of them. Wow. Yeah, this is looking pretty good now. I think with the north-south, it'll really help. I think maybe a little bit more X. Really? You can do that with the partnership with Twitch? Crazy. All right, yes. All we need to do is get like a billion more viewers. Let's try a third there on the X. Okay, now let's add the ability to squish on the north-south. Yes, all right. Yeah, it is kind of cool, right? That would be funny, though, a whole trailer of just squishing grass. Oh, it's no worries, man. Yeah, dude, don't worry. You don't have to say that. I know y'all got different things you got to be doing and stuff. You mean you would try and trample as much grass as you can, or you would not? It is looking pretty good, right? Oh, I know, yeah, you get busy, right? All right, Arcor, good night, man. See ya, thanks for joining, man. Pierre's culinary adventure. I love how he's like, dude, he's already becoming an iconic character. Oh, this is like the overall map or whatever? Yes, go to that level, go to that plate. Go to that plate. Go to the plate, man. Yeah. All right. You went to the plate. Oh, whoa. Look at that. You got platforms you can break through. Cool. Looking good, man. You got some new mechanics in here. Right on. Don't go in the frying pan, Pierre. Don't do it. Oh no, he's gonna do it. He's gonna do. Oh, Pierre. Right on, Tryhard Monkey. Yeah, cool. All right, so when we're squishing on the XY, we want to set the scale Y to be something. I'm thinking maybe a 7/10 is tall. Scale big Y. And then the angle that we're going to rotate is going to be pretty much just a little bit to the left or the right. So all we need to do is subtract about half the rand angle. All right, let's try that. Now we should have some north-south squishing going on. Squish, squish, squish. Squishy, squish. Oh, wait. If the rand plus if e dot move dot last north south dir equals k dir south, then we want to rotate a whole 180. Otherwise, just keep it like it is. There. Okay, this might be complete. This whole technique might be finished at this point if this is looking good. That'd be another thing to cross off the list today. Whoa. Gosh, a lot of progress today. Cool. Yeah, right on. I can't wait to see you add some juice to the game. For sure. All the animations and stuff. Oh, that's okay. So that's squished wrong. Oh, you know what? It does need a grass smash sound for sure. Eklof, what's up, man? Welcome to the stream. And actually, this is one of the requirements for Retro VGS, because all the Retro VGS cartridges come with old school manuals. So yeah, I'm gonna have to do a PDF anyways, and I might as well do it for the Steam release too. Good call, man. Yeah, old school manual. We'll have to crack out some old NES manuals and see what the heck they look like again. Kind of try and get that aesthetic going. Oh, nice, right on. He's looking for the perfect mushroom dish. Awesome, man. That gives him a lot of character. He already has a lot of character. That's really cool. You're developing. You have an asset now. You really do. You have like a character, an endearing character. So actually, this thing, we should be basing it off the player's current direction. So if the if we know we can get the compass direction. If dir equals k dir none, dir equals e dot move dot last compass dir. Now if dir equals k dir west or dir equals k dir east, dir equals k dir north or 4K. There. So now we got a we should have a robust direction of last movement, and then checking if it's west or east or north or south. That way, because we always have these last east west and last north south directions. That's why when I was trampling north south, it was doing those east west effects. So hopefully this fixes that without breaking anything. Oh yeah, that looked like it squished down. Oh, there, and yeah, so that squished all the way over. But we really wanna, when we're squishing south, we really wanna do way less Y scale. So if it's south, we wanna do like really low, like 1.1. Oh man, lame. Dude, I haven't used Microsoft Word in, hell, 20 years maybe? Oh, okay, okay. So the thing with that was that we rotated a whole 180 degrees and that just didn't look that good. So really, we don't even need this. Basically, we'll just leave the direction alone, whether it's north or south. Then the real trample effect will happen with the scale there. Yes, good for you, man. WordPad for the win. WordPad all the way. Notepad++? I'm trying to think of Windows text editor. How about Atom? Atom's really good, cross-platform. There's also TextMate. Is TextMate for Windows? Sublime text editor, another great one. Straight up Notepad for the win. How about MS Edit for DOS? Any takers? Yeah, that looked better. So that's a cool north-south trample. Well, that's a little bit too much though. Maybe 0.2 to 0.25. Let's try 0.25. Slick Edit? Is there a Notepad minus minus? Dude, really? Is there really a Notepad minus minus? Yes, that's what I'm talking about. MS Edit. Oh. I wrote my first game in edit.exe. It was all in one file. I wrote it in C. And this was in 1995. I was 15 years old. And it was all in one file. Yeah, I think this is working pretty well. I think I want it to be a little bit taller, though. Yes, I think I'm now a Vim person. I've switched from, I used to use Nano all the time. But now Nano is like almost foreign to me. I keep on wanting to hit Escape Q to exit this, but I remember it's Control X. But now I'm Vim. Bam, something, 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 something. Whoops. You can tell I'm still not that good with Bim. Cryptic Silver, best joke ever. Where are they? Still trying to quit Bim. Like I just did right there. Is it okay? Tell me, is there really a Notepad minus minus? This is like, this would be news to me. No, there isn't. Oh man, somebody should make a Notepad minus minus. Oh, there's an opportunity right there. Anybody wants to make a rad Notepad minus minus? A Locarno. Hey, interesting. Should there be a random chance for a rupee? Yes, of course there should. Let's do it right now. Good call. Very good call, man. Let's delete this. We don't want that. And let's do a random chance. If D-Rand F a 1. Come on, do I have to hit escape? Oh, there you go. D-Rand F a 1 is less than something, some low probability. Let's give it, because there's a lot of these entities, so let's do 0.05 to start with. What's its features? They're all, it's like nothing, no features. Breakable pots. I know. Yeah, that would be so Zelda. I don't know if I can be, I mean, this game's already pretty much Zelda, but maybe something else, maybe something besides pots. This, actually just world area. Do we already have that? Yeah, we do. Area.createItem. I think that's all there is to it. Yeah, item type. K, item, diamond, pause, right here. E.position.pause. Wait, but that's gonna put it right by the player, so. You can't change the font, no wrapping lines. There's only one line. Yes. Yeah, it says there already is bombs. Yeah, there's lots of bombs and secrets. I haven't used bombs in a long time. I just got to put that item back in. I think I have bomb containers, but... Oh, yeah, and I do have bombs. Oh, I already have this. Okay. Yeah, there's bombs, man. Okay, that's gonna put a diamond right underneath your feet, so you're just gonna instantly pick it up. But let's, if only there's a way to, like, I guess I would have to, like, maybe put the item somewhere else, or maybe Jib can scan this squished grass for stuff. Yep, there's bombs, man. Check it out. Oh, and if anybody hasn't seen, I've separated the items finally into equipment, which is equipable stuff. Like, you can use it on your B item and your gear and skills. So there's actually going to be skills as well as gear items. So here's your items you basically just cannot select and use. But yeah, you can use bombs, and you got to get out of the way, because if you sit by your bomb, you'll get hurt. But yeah, this can actually open up secrets. Like, if that was a secret entrance or something, you can open a secret that way. Oh yeah, we're getting items. Oh, that's great. Oh, dude, Locarno. Awesome idea. Hey, what's up, Xbox Taco? Yes, we all missed you. We were crying, dude. I was actually in tears. Why the zero? Because that was originally, that is the save number, your slot for your game. So there, you can have up to three different save games. And so zero is the first one, one would be the second one, two would be the third one. And, you know, maybe later on I'll make it so you can even have more, like 5 or 10 different save games or whatever. I don't know. I guess I could do that, but it's kind of cool that you just pick it up immediately. Yeah, man, you should be. Seriously. Gosh. Yeah, so less random chance. I'm thinking maybe like 0.02. And I guess we could add a random position. Let's try adding a little bit of random position to that. See if it would... Yeah. Slightly on the... Yeah, okay, let's do Vec2. DRAND F times 4. And DRAND F times 3. Bombs, yeah, man. Sorry, I haven't showed bombs in a long time. That's like one of those items where I should be showing it more often. But yeah, Bombs are fun. You can kill enemies pretty well with them too, because they're really strong. And they're difficult to actually hit an enemy with because they have to go bleep, 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 boom. So it, you know, that timing of it's kind of tricky to hit an enemy with. What? We're not getting any items now. Come on, man, I want some diamonds. Oh, I guess maybe I made it too low. Whoops. Let's try that with maybe a little high. I guess it's 0.02. It should be fine. Man, what a productive day. Jeez, I still got half the day left. This makes me feel really good for the release coming up later this month. No items? No love? Oh, there we go. There's some. It's kind of cool how it actually flashes there for a second. So it's like you can see it, but you immediately pick it up. So it's like, it's almost like a surprise. You're like, what? What just happened? I guess the probability is a little high, though, still. So let's see if that works with the 0.02. It should. I mean, we're getting a DRAN, a random number between 0 and, like, 1,000. So, yeah. DRAN max. What's that? OXFFFF. That's, like, isn't that 4 billion? Or close, or 2 billion? Yeah, this should be plenty to get a number below 1%. Good call, Locarno. You think they should jump out and you should have a cooldown? That would probably be pretty interesting, huh? Yeah. Well, how could we give him a cooldown? It's weird, when I put it to 2%, it's like they don't appear anymore. Either that or they're just so rare. Oh, there's one. I guess they were just a little more rare. So, if you come back on the screen, they're all no longer trampled. So, it would be better if I could keep things trampled. So, yeah, I just should put some kind of memory in here so it remembers the fact that you've trampled over something, so you're not like able to go back and just make money like crazy. Okay, the easiest way to do that would be to make it so it just randomly has. I mean, yeah, okay, so if we were to do it the easy way, it wouldn't really work long term. So I guess if I'm going to do this, I need to do it the right way. Does it? Zelda just regrows the grass? It's, oh, good point. Right. Yeah, I remember. So for like Link to the Past or whatever, you go off screen. If you just wait, it regrows the grass? Whoa. Right? Me neither. It's been a minute since I played Zelda 3. I think I started playing it actually recently, but I didn't get past like level 2. Eye shooting lasers? Yes. Yes. I think that was level 2. I think that was actually level 2 when they first had those in Zelda 3. You want OS X versus Windows? Flame war going on. Item cooldown. How could it? Oh, I got it. totally got this. Yeah. We'll set its category something random, like area. So we'll get the last entity that was created, right? Oh, arch? Hey, what's arch? Sorry, I'm probably an idiot for asking that, but I've never heard of arch. Is this an actual OS? I thought you were talking about arch like architecture. Whoa! It's okay, so it's a Linux distro? Oh, it's a Linux distro for tablets and smartphones? Is that what it is? What up, Dumbtard? I like Slackware myself. Slackware, I mean, I guess I love Debian too, but yeah, dude, Slackware is rad. Ubuntu is, of course, great. Create item, here we go. I think this first creates one single entity. So yeah, all we gotta do is to add a little cooldown to an item. We just grab the last item and we're gonna set its collision category and then run an action. So we need to get the system int. This is just int in this method. Oh, we need the last item. Oh, all right. Oh, so it's not specifically for him. Okay. So what makes it special? Why would you say Arch OS X Windows and not Linux? What's so special about Arch? Yeah, there's that. That's why I got Windows on boot camp. Oh, I think create item actually returns the it returns the EID. Okay, done. So we would go int f area create item. Now so we would just make set f dot collision dot category. We're gonna set this to be like none. And then set a timer, which sets it back to item or whatever. R2, you started on Slackware. Cool. Red Hat. Cool. Gen 2. I never tried Gen 2. I tried Red Hat. It's praised for its simplicity. Not simplicity that's easy for beginner, but yeah. Oh, cool. Bare bones. That's also kind of Slackware-ish. Nice, rad. Okay, so is it really small then too? So like you could throw it on like a flash drive or whatever and run it? Because that would be sick to have just like a pocket Linux distro. Cool. How big is it? How big is it, like the basic CLI only version? Yeah, kfilter item. Cool. So we're just going to take off kfilter item. Why would you get in trouble for that? I guess because you might have a virus or whatever. All right, f.collision.category is none, and then f.render.sprite.runAction, or schedule once is fine. So we need a function that takes a float. We're not gonna just do this float. I guess we would, we need the EID for this guy. Whoa, under 500 megs? Awesome. Oh, yeah. Oh, really? 16 gigs is standard flash now? I got this crazy old one. It's only 2 gigs. This thing is ancient. Ancient 2 gig flash thing, still rocking it. Yeah, totally. Whoa, Dragon Linux? 1.5 megs? That's amazing. Nice one, Espresso. Whoa. Dang. Got some fast net. So what's this delay gonna be? Maybe like half a second or something like that. You can't pick it up. So we'll go entity get collision component for item ID dot category K filter item. Done. There we go. Wow. Whoa. When I was in high school, we didn't even have flash drives. Not at all. When I was in high school, we barely had the internet. Let the items fly. Where are you, items? Come on. Come on out. I guess I should make this probability higher for this whole testing phase here. There's one. Oh, it works. Nice. That works well. So you can, like, you're like, what? What? An item? Yeah. Oh, I like that. Okay, well, now let's make it fly now a little bit. Right. 300 baud modems. Oh, that's old school right there. That's painfully old school. Ouch. F dot move. Oh, we need, I guess we need to add a move component here. None. Oh, yeah. Pretty much when I was at when I was in high school, it was pretty much still the BBS days, 1995 or whatever. Yeah, and then we started getting the internet in like 96, at least in my area, sort of. Actually, in 94, I guess we had the internet, but that was really only. Like if you had the money to pay for it or whatever. Don't think an item has a move component. This wouldn't make sense. Yeah, okay, so we need to give this thing a move component to be able to jump out of the grass or whatever. So we'll add a move component to these jumping items. Entity add component. New move component. These things take a mask, speed, acceleration, deceleration. So the mask for this thing is going to be what you cannot move on, which is going to be. We don't want to move on to static. We don't want to move these things on to. Water. We don't want to move them on to sky. But basically everything else. So what was that again? Size or something? Speed, acceleration, deceleration. Speed, what was that? Speed is a vec2? Vec2. I think it was something like 90, 70. How long does it take to accelerate? Maybe a third of a second. To decelerate, maybe a half second. There. Whoa, yeah, Windows 3.1 trumpet. Oh my god, yeah, unfortunately I didn't get to get to using Linux until I went to college in 98, so that's when my eyes were opened to the power of Unix. Oh, thank you, Unix. Move.zxl, I think it's called zxl. Yeah, zxl. I don't know what this should be, but we'll try a point half. f.move.velocity or excel. I thought this thing had an acceleration. Is that position? What? Hi, Memsis. Oh, gosh, I can't believe you guys remember all this stuff. But when you just when you say things like "Hi, Memsis," I'm like, oh my god, those days. Those days, crazy days. Before all this awesomeness we have today's. Back then, I guess it was still awesome though. I think it's the move component. Yeah, we got velocity. CXL, Z velocity. Which these should really be 3D instead. DOS AOL. DOS AOL. All right, I don't know if this is gonna work. So I'm gonna run it, see what happens. That's right, they did. It was basically like, back then we were like, AOL. What is AOL? Oh, probability. Increase the probability so this isn't so hard to debug. Dude, let's make it 1. Let's make it all the way 100%. Alright, 2 hours. I guess this is about it for the stream. I'm gonna run this, I'm gonna get this working before I go, so at least 5 more minutes, but just doing the 5-minute call there. Oh! Yes, diamonds everywhere! Diamonds, diamonds, diamonds! But they're not jumping yet. Why aren't you jumping? You're from 96? What do you mean? You're born in 96? Alright, PETA. Good night, man. Prodigy. Yeah. Yeah. Let's just try a really high ZXL. I think that's not really high yet, but let's try a bigger velocity. Yeah, man. Good night, dude. 97. Whoa. I was 17 years old then. That's cool, man. Sounds like you got a good head on your shoulders for being so young, man. Why aren't these things flying? Oh, they are. They totally are. I'm gonna turn that up. I thought it derived velocity from something. You were born in 00? Good for you, dude. You've been programming since you're 11? Good, dude. That's awesome. Acceleration. How does acceleration work here? That should give it some jump, though. Yeah. Dude, you're as old as Wolverine. Now they're getting a little bit of jump. Okay, so this needs to be big. Maybe this needs to be huge. Whoa, pretty close. Yeah. Wow, you were born right before the world was about to end. 99, you're from the last millennium, dude. Yeah, that's definitely fun having them bounce up like that. But they're still not really... Actually, just that little jump is actually enough, I think. I don't even think it really needs to jump to the side. This is great. Woo! I'm rich! Maybe you could get an item that, like, always makes you get tons of diamonds from grass. Everywhere I go, there's diamonds. This is the greatest thing ever. I can't believe this was just a low priority item. This should have been high priority. So good. Yes. Whoa, cool, man. What was Y2K like? Everybody literally thought was afraid. Everybody was so afraid. It was like 2012 kind of. Everybody was like kind of afraid of 2012, but people were more afraid, I think, of Y2K than they were of 2012 or anything else I've seen. People were freaked out, dude. Everybody thought all the banks would go offline and that all society would crumble. And we were all holding our breaths and everybody was like, "Oh my god, it's Y2K." And then the next day, nothing happened, and everybody's like, okay, I guess everything's fine. Yes, dude. Arcane is Unix. Dude, you're like the movie Lucy. You're like Lucy. You're up in everything. You are everything. Let's figure out what's up with that velocity, though. Velocity... Yeah, that's all you have to do is set a velocity. I wonder why that's not working. Oh well. I think this is pretty fun. I like this as it is. I'm gonna run this one more time, pick up some items, and that's it for today's stream, you guys. Don't forget the flat gas, remember? Yeah, I'll do that. Oh, it's not your actual birthday? Oh, dude, we were so stoked. Yeah, I know, right? Yeah. That's when I learned that like you really shouldn't be afraid of stuff. Or not as afraid as people think you should be, you know? Take things with a grain of salt, think for yourself, that kind of stuff. This is great. Diamonds, 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 diamonds! Diamonds everywhere! All right, yeah, so that's it for today's stream. If anybody is just joining the stream right now and you're like, what the hell is this? This is a game called Songbringer. It's a Zelda-like game. It's procedurally generated. It's coming out this January for Steam, Windows, Mac, and Linux. So yeah, that's it for today's stream, and I had a good time today, and yeah, have a good night, you guys. Thanks for joining the stream. Thanks for making me laugh. Thanks for all the awesome conversation and everything too. So appreciate you all. Yeah, and happy birthday, Vlad. Flood. See ya.